Okay, it's April 15th, 2015, 2016. On the video I said about the railroad tracks being replaced and all that, I said April, I don't know what I said, 5th or 6th or something, but it's the 15th, Friday the 15th of April, 2016. And because of the hellish wind we've had out here, we tried plastic out here before, used for wrapping loads when you load truck trailers and whatnot. I have more those tomato steaks, and I have more also all around here, and I was trying to wrap it with plastic to make like a barrier right here, which was a joke because we were doing it while it was real windy. The winds out here, when they tell you it says 12 miles an hour with 17 mile an hour wind gusts. Look at the condition of these things. Look at that one. That was a pretty decent pepper. It was 18 inches tall when it was in the house. We brought it out here, full of leaves and everything. But the wind out here has wreaked havoc on it. So, wreaked havoc, however you want to put it. But anyway, that's there. I was going to look over here at the garden. Because I have torch sunflowers, which are the orange ones that get the big glowing butterflies, honeybees, and even hummingbirds. And the yellow traditional sunflower type seeds for the Titan. And you can see there's different types down there. Plus I put two other types of flowers that are medicinal type flowers from solutions from science and heirloom solutions pretty much work together hand in hand, I guess you said. They're interconnected. And I planted a bunch of them down here, so when they all start coming up, you'll see that. Here's my little CJ Friday. She would have been 10 years old. Anyway, I did the same thing. I had other flowers right down here. I did 3, 4, 5 that way. And then I got, look at all these. They're real close. I'm going to have to weed these out. I want them thick, but I don't know if I want them this thick. You know, because when they get up here, I mean, it'll be my natural wind barrier for all this. Look at this. Little wind out here. It's blowing south. It's coming out of the southeast. Now it's coming out of the southwest. Okay. See, that's why I purposely put these out here. It looks trashy to some people. But I've got these up here for a reason. I look out my windows and I can see how strong the wind's blowing and what direction. Okay, that's the southeast wind now. I mean, southwest wind. Blowing southwest, going northeast. But anyway, I just want to real quickly look at all the sunflowers, how they're coming up now. First, I wasn't sure if I had enough out here. You think I got enough out here now? Okay. See, in here it gets a little sporadic. Again, every so many feet, though, I put different types of flowers, the ones that are medicinal, mixed in here with these. But primarily, it's 90% torch sunflower and regular yellow-head sunflowers, the Titan type. And then these other flowers mixed in. But you can see all around the border here. You see all those sunflowers. Look at all of that. That's where I drop seeds or something like that. Look at that. That's too many. But again, I'll weed them out as they get about 2 feet tall. Plus, the deer out here have come out here. And we had them close right up on the garden last year. And the deer ate 70%, or no, I'd say about 40% of what was over here. Ate them down. About as tall as that dandelion there. And they came back. You know, the deer, you know, I kind of kept them away. I did something that was supposed to help keep them away, and it did. But look at all the sunflowers down here. See, it doesn't look so great right now, but as it gets grown up and everything, and then you can trim it out better too, as far as with all the grass and whatnot. I would like to have more back, like I have over there on the far end. I'd like to have down this way, all in here. I'd like to have them real thick like that, all the way to this corner. But see, over here on this end, this is the east end. There's a bee there, I don't want to bother. This is the east end. They just don't seem to grow so well over here. I mean, there are some down there. But this one, too, has those other flowers. I have them medicinal type. There. See, there's little bunches. But then, like in here, I'm guessing, I forget how many feet I was doing, every 6 feet or 8 feet. I was doing a row going this way here with certain flowers. They'll mix in with them. So maybe around May, the end of May, into June, you'll see some up here. The sunflower should be about 18 inches tall here by June. Okay. And then where this break is right here, see that? This is the break in between the gardens here. I planted some down there, I know that for sure. And more sunflowers. Titan and the yellow, the orange torch. I'm not positive, but I believe the ones that look like the four leaf type, those are torch. And I really can't tell the difference. The Titan, the yellow ones. See, when they first come up, it's just like two leaves. And I can't see this too good without my glasses, but I think like that right there. But I don't know. They're mixed in. And today's Friday, Sunday. We're going to come out here and take this plastic up. And we're going to till this one. And then I'm going to put down my zucchini over here and my cucumbers. I'm doing it the old-fashioned way, the pioneer type way. I'm making a tripod type trellis from branches. I mean, like I said, I do buy stuff in the store, you know, we have to, but like I got these long branches here that are about 6 foot. Some of them might be about 7 foot. I got some back there on the plastic holding it down with the wind. But I'm gonna make little tripods out here, trellises, and have my cucumbers and like I said, zucchini. It'll be like three golden zucchini. I only have one seed of the black beauty, which is the green zucchini, which will go over here too. I've got beans planted. I got watermelon and cantaloupe over there in the first three holes. I got like two watermelons, with a long watermelon, then the sugar baby, and I don't know if it's another sugar baby, and then I've got like two cantaloupes and a watermelon, whatever, back there. But I've got six planted total, six locations. But then I've got beans down here, here, there, and there, all planted by seed. And then I've got these. I'm gonna put fencing in between every two tomato stakes. We've got wire fencing. It's 3 foot tall. I'd say, you know, it's about this tall here. And we'll just cut. I'll measure this and cut a strip here, and then I'll cut a strip for those two. And then I'll use about four strings going from the last one to that one there, and so forth, as a trellis for it to grow on. And I'd like to get those green tomato steaks at Lowe's. They were 48, I believe, in a bag for $7. I might get more of those. And one more roll of 50-foot roll of fencing again also would be good. Not necessarily needed right now, but it would be good to have. And just in case, I'd like to have it for extra. But then I just cut some other places here in the plastic where I'm going to plant beans and all that. Like I say, tomorrow is Saturday. I might come out here and plant some of this. Right there, right there, in there, and right there. You can see the little pieces I cut off, like half of it. See, instead of having the X and just folding the plastic, it's very difficult, as you can see, as you've seen in the back there. The plastic keeps coming undone. Until the plant starts growing, you got to keep it, try to keep it folded underneath. You want to try to keep it like this right there. Okay, but with the wind out here, and you see, that's why I got all this stuff all over here. I got boards. Bottles, we have water in them now to hold the plastic down, detergent, cinder blocks. I mean, the wind out here has been, from hell. I mean, like I say, you just look at this. See, I have these out here. When I'm in the house, I can look out and see, you know, the direction and how strong the wind is. And when you get up and at 7 o'clock in the morning, I would say 6 to about 7, maybe 7:30, it might be just, you know, it might just be laying like that right there. But then, coming out at 7:30 or so, then the wind starts picking up. Now it's coming out of the south. Yeah, southeast. That's blowing out of the southeast. Southeast wind there. So, this one here is the first thing tomorrow. And not tomorrow, probably Sunday. Because look at the water on here still. It'll be wet. It's moist underneath it, which you want that anyway. Because that's what helps it grow. The heat's supposed to be cool. It's about 10 degrees warmer at least underneath these plastic ones with the sun on it, especially. It may rain a little bit today. I don't think it's going to. But this is the one that surprised me the most. The plastic on this one, the number one garden, was always so good. Last year we put it down in January, February, and we buried it, and it's been real good. Now, like I said, because of this wind, and all I can do is show you that. You see how those things are blowing around there? Look at, that's how strong the wind is out here. 90% of the time, and I'm not exaggerating either. 90% of the time, that's how the wind's blowing out here. After 7:30 in the morning, boom. I mean, you can come out here at like 8:30, 9 o'clock at night, it's starting to get dark, but then it's too late to be doing it to start something like this. Just look at the plastic from the holes of previous, from last year, and it gets underneath there. The plastic is a great thing. It will really help this garden explode again this summer. My onions that I had originally planted here, I had like three rows. I broke up the ground with that bow rake I had somewhere around. Oh, that bow rake. Let me see if I can zoom in on it. That bow rake right there. See those teeth, solid teeth? I was over here, and I raked it this way. And I had like three rows, and I put down onion seeds. Because if I plant them in late February, early March, plant them, and then in about the end of April, they should start to come up, and by September, you'd have onions. But the rain flooded all this. We planted six garlic here, cloves, last year in November, the first week of November, and they're coming up. They'll be done. They'll be ready by the end of June. Then we planted two more rows, six in each row down here. But again, it's flooded so bad out here, it washed up a couple of the clothes. I can't see with the wind blowing my hair in my face right now, but I've got the clove down there. You can see it almost looks like it's coming up out of the ground. I think that's it. This autofocus isn't working so great either because, well, you know, they spray the shit in the sky, so. Anyway, there's a row there. There's a row right there. You can see one, two, three of them there. Over here you see one, two, three, four. Because see how it's all off and everything? From the rain, washing everything around. So, this garlic will be ready by December. This will be ready by the end of June, or about by the end of July at the latest. And then by the first week, second week of December, we have garlic here. So over there will be okra, and I'm not sure exactly here yet. I'm going to have cucumber over there, zucchini. I don't know if I have eggplant over here or eggplant over in this one. This is number one garden. This is number two garden, and the back one's number three garden. That's where all the long, viney stuff's going. I mean, the cucumber would need to go back there, but I figured we'd try, like I say, old-fashioned way with the homemade trellis with the long branches I had gotten over the last 3 years, because the wind out here, when you have a bad storm, sometimes it breaks off the branches off these big old trees out here. But this year we've been windy out of 30 days, we've probably been windy about 26 days. Okay, so, and like I said, that's the wind. Not, and I'm not talking about a light breeze, it's a steady wind with gusts. And I understand it's spring, but we've been out here for 4 years, okay? This is the first time it's been like this. It's been, again, I don't know. There's a lot of things people aren't realizing, you know. Back in March 11, 2011, HARP, look it up, HARP, sent an electric shock into the ionosphere. Ooh, boom, guess what? Tsunami. Tidal wave, nuclear, major fallout direct, which most people have no clue about that still. The worst nuclear disaster in human history happened on March 11, 2011, Fukushima, Japan, and the radiation has gone around this planet probably about 8, 10, 12, 15 times maybe by now. This stuff might even be radioactive. I don't have a Geiger counter, but, you know, it could be. But the winds, all of this stuff has got to be tied together because, you know, for us to be here for 4 years, and then this year, of all these years, it looks like that all the time. All the wind. So, unless you think you know better, which I know you don't, but, you know, if you think you know better, maybe you got some suggestions without being stupid or vulgar or, you know, just the plain old assholes, which so many people are out there. I'm not kind of calling anybody an asshole, I'm just saying. People make snide remarks because they have no clue, and they just got, I got my two sons, I can show him, I'll tell him, you know, whatever. But, you know, this will be a really, really good garden. Come Sunday, we're gonna till up that one and this one here. We'll have to get the plastic up and till it, and I'll do a video on that. This is gonna be a long video already. It's 15 minutes. Sorry for it to go so long, but I was just showing a little bit of everything. I've got what they call diarrhea of the mouth. There's nothing you can take for that. So we'll till up that one and this one here, and then we'll plant the cucumber and the zucchini over there, and then I'm gonna go ahead and start. I'm gonna plant the okra over here. They should have been planted. They should be planted anytime now for the next 2 weeks. So they'll be over here. Don't know yet still with these last little two area rows. Tomatoes next Saturday or Friday. Next Friday would be CJ's 10th birthday, and she passed away after she was 7 years old. She ended up with cancer after we moved out here. Geez, let's see. Monsanto farmland, glyphosate, all around us. Huh. I'm sure there's no connection though, right? Anyway, I'll get started now. I get really pissed off. Anyway, so CJ's birthday, she'd be 10 next Friday. I mean, think maybe if I can hold off with those tomatoes, I might put them out next Friday. Surely the wind will stop.